You know, yesterday I was looking at my big cat, Mr. Grumps, and I put my face like right next to his, and I just watch, you know, like his profile with his eyes, and I watch him, you know, he's blinking, and you know, I just think when I look at him, like, you know, life. We don't really talk about life. You know, like, what is life? Like, how does something have life in it? Like, things are alive. We just don't even think about it. If he didn't have life, he would be a teddy bear or a stuffed animal, you know? And it's like, that's why Satan, they call it artificial life or artificial intelligence. Well, what's artificial? It's not real, you know? It's not real in real intelligence. It's not real life. Satan can't make a cat, you know? So if Satan was who he claims to be, he would take all his friends and go to a different planet and make something up himself, but he can't, because he is a created being. So, you know, that's why they want to merge with artificial intelligence. And you know, it's just funny when you think about it, like, things are alive, you know? Things are alive, and that's just something that science cannot duplicate. And when you look at batteries, let me see, I don't think I have the batteries here, but batteries have the lightning bolt on them, a lot of them do, and that's a Luciferian symbol too, you know, because things need, you know, false light, you know, false batteries, false, you know, energy, you know, to animate themselves. And it's just, you know, I don't know. I just don't know if people realize that, like, if there was only evolution, your DNA would just say male human or female human. It wouldn't have, you know, your DNA would be no different than your neighbor's. It would just be human, male, you know, whatever. If there wouldn't be 9 billion differentials in codes that you are who you are, and there's no one else that has the same code or schematics or whatever. It would not be a possible thing. There's no way evolution made up, you know. It's like I was just looking at my cat's hair, you know, like a strand of hair, and I was like, all this information is inside here, and it's been inside here for thousands of years, and we're just catching up to it, you know. We didn't invent DNA. DNA's always been there. We're just finding it, you know? We're just finding the chromosomal, you know, information. We're trying, and they're trying to manipulate it. They're trying to, you know, do what they're trying to do with this RNA vaccine. So I was just thinking about it. You know, there was nothing, and, you know, it was just like I was holding my cat, and I was looking at him and going, you know, God just came up out of thin air and designed this. You know, he just said, hey, you know what, I'm going to make a little furry, I don't know, kind of looks like a wombat and a beaver mixed together and a mountain lion, and call it a cat, because I'm bored, you know what I mean, because I want humans to have stuff to play with, you know. So it's like, you know, like I've told people, here's an exercise for you, don't use anything that's on Earth, okay, don't use anything on Earth. And make up your own, like, planet, you know. Don't use trees, don't use oxygen, don't use creatures, just everything completely. There's no colors, there's no nothing, there's no language, there's nothing, because that's all God's creation. There's no sun, there's no moon, and, you know, see what you come up with. That isn't artificial intelligence, okay? That is the alpha and omega. So when people try to tell me stuff about evolution, I just blast them off with that. You know what I mean? There would still be monkeys walking out of the woods going, hey, where do I go when I'm half monkey and half human? You know, is there a support group or something for me, or a Facebook page I can maybe, you know, get some benefits, or what do I do?